Next.
Is there a beauty about working in television that you can explore kind of different facets of a personality, of the character, because you've got more time?
Yeah, long-form drama, yeah. Yes, yeah, yeah, long-form drama always offers you options and possibilities of exploring your character. I mean, you got to do Cillian over four seasons.
Yeah, four seasons. And it's a really strange one because you as much as you make choices and you develop the character, and there's a kind of weird mix of you have your ideas of where you think or who you think the character is, and then suddenly you get a script that you go, oh, he does that. I didn't. That's different. Okay, so you're kind of, as much as you're putting the work in deciding who he is, then you're being given, someone else has a different idea. And I think with Leo, that's why I quite liked where my character came from, and the fact that I was only meant to be in a couple of episodes, and then it was, oh, actually, he's quite useful. And then it kind of developed very organically and nicely to a point that he becomes he is a much more important figure in Camelot. And so there's a few things that the writers by the end had our personalities, the little things that we brought, they've managed to capture it and allowed us that freedom and silliness. And, you know, it was a nice mix of being emotionally inept and very good at fighting, you know, I think as the kind of group of knights in a way. There was that slight, yeah, that lovely thing of being.
I think long form drama offers, like with like, not only does it offer you a chance to inhabit a character and explore different facets of their personality, but it also offers you a chance to discover who you are as a person as well. And depending on the role, obviously, but like when I was doing Philippe for Versailles, it felt like I didn't know where the character started and I ended in sort of that blur, because you were over three seasons, you got to explore different aspects of the character's personality, but then it also offered you questions about, well, would I have done that? And do you know what I mean? So yeah, the long form drama is a great way, and hence why loads of now Hollywood stars are coming in and it feels like they're not dropping down, but that's what they say, we're dropping down to do television. But that's why it's called the golden age of TV, because you've got people like Pacino doing a series, and you've got, you know, Matthew McConaughey and Woody Harrelson doing True Detective, and you've got, you know, big film stars dropping down to do television, because they get to explore rather than a 2.5 hour movie, they get to explore 10 hours. In America, sometimes it's 26 episodes, isn't it? Sometimes half hour episodes. So yeah, it's the best way.
Is it interesting when you're working on long form that, you know, when you're working on a feature, you're working with one director and one vision, and then when you end up working in TV, there's often different directors working on each episode. So is that challenging to have to kind of, I suppose, adapt to their vision?
I think at the time for me, I don't mean to speak for Rupert, but for me it was always like you just get used to a director's style. And suddenly, and then you're just getting used to their, you know, you're into their 3-week shoot of their block, and you're just getting used to, oh, that's what they're looking for. Okay, get it. And then they're off. And then suddenly, oh, hello, you're the new person. Hello, come in. Yes. And, oh, you're very different. Okay, wow. And then you just sort of get used to them. You know, we had like four directors. Justin did on season 5 of Merlin. And, you know, and there's a quick turnaround as well. So, you know, and every actor on every series has a favourite, you know, I really like that person, I didn't like him, you know, all this sort of stuff. Because styles are different, you know. Yes, the end goal is to make the TV show that everyone loves, but they might be a technical director that, you know, that don't really know how to talk to actors. Some people are very actor orientated, and was that the helicopter?
Mm-hmm. Brilliant. That's the thing you don't mention. You pretend you haven't seen
it. Oh, I haven't seen it, so cut that out, rewind, there you go, put it back in the pocket. But yeah.
But I think you do have those, and I found it fascinating the different directors you get to work with and what they bring. And sometimes your favourite are a producer's least favourite because they take more time with the actors and go right to try and develop, and they're like, no, this is schedule. And but you're also, just like life, you meet people that you connect with and you meet people you don't connect with as much. And but when you work with, there are people I would do anything for, you know, their phone said, do you want to do this? I'm like, yeah, do you want to read it? No, I'll work with you. But there are, I think sometimes you help develop a character, or they help you take a character down a different route, or some are more focused on the fight, some are more focused on, so there is a challenge, and I think it's good to keep, as an actor, you on your feet, because if you have the same person, then I think,
yeah, there's no chance of getting complacent.
Yeah, and sometimes you can disagree, and the more you've been in something, you can go, well, I don't know, I think that it's a very, TV is a collaborative process, and I think it needs to continue to do that, to be. And sometimes you get egos, or people think they know more than you hope that everyone at the top of the game in whatever role they fill. So you have to listen to people. Not always agree, but listen and collaborate. So
fantastic.